एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल माई सेल्फ अल्फिया कुरैशी। सो इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी टॉक्ड अबाउट ब्रेकियल आर्टरी एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द रेडियल आर्टरी व्हिच इज द स्मॉलर टर्मिनल ब्रांच ऑफ ब्रेकियल आर्टरी। ओके, सो दिस इज अ डायग्राम ऑफ रेडियल आर्टरी। ओके, दिस ब्रेकियल आर्टरी एंड द ब्रेकियल आर्टरी देन टर्मिनेट्स इन टू टू ब्रांचेस व्हिच इज रेडियल आर्टरी एंड दिस वन इज द अल्नर आर्टरी एट द नेक ऑफ रेडियस बोन। दिस इज रेडियस बोन एंड दिस इज अल्ना बोन। ओके, सो दिस रेडियल आर्टरी रन्स डाउनवर्ड हैविंग अ स्लाइटली लेटरल कॉन्वेक्सिटी एंड रनिंग डाउनवर्ड एंड इट वाइंड्स पोस्टीरियरली एंटर इन टू एनाटमिकल स्नफ बॉक्स एंड देन इट पार्टिसिपेट इन टू द डीप एंड सुपरफिशियल पामर आर्चेस। ओके, सो द ओरिजिन ऑफ रेडियल आर्टरी इज एट द नेक ऑफ रेडियस बोन। ओके, एंड द टर्मिनेशन इज इन द पाम गिविंग ब्रांचेस टू द मसल्स और पार्टिसिपेटिंग इन द सुपरफिशियल एंड डीप पामर आर्चेस। ओके, सो दिस ओरिजिन एंड टर्मिनेशन। Now, its course is superficial and half of its course and half of its course is covered by a muscle. Okay, so now let's talk about the relations. Anterior relation. So these are the two diagrams for relation. This diagram is showing the posterior relation and this diagram is showing the anterior, lateral and medial relation. Okay, so in this diagram you guys can see this is the brachial artery. Okay, this is bicep muscle and this is bicipital aponeurosis. This is the region of elbow. So here this brachial artery is dividing into radial and ulnar artery. So this one is the ulnar artery and this one is the radial artery. Okay, this right is the radial artery and this muscle is the brachioradialis, which is covering this artery in half of its course and then it is superficial, you can see. Okay. So in the anterior relation you guys can see this is the brachioradialis muscle which is covering half of its course and then it is superficial and so the anterior relation is brachioradialis muscle in the upper part okay and in the lower part there is skin and superficial fascia. Okay, now let's see the posterior relation. So for the posterior relation we have this diagram in which all the superficial muscles which are covering this region are removed to make the posterior relations clear. Okay, so starting from here, first of all this is the bicep tendon which is in the posterior relation, then supinator muscle. Okay, then coming down there is pronator teres muscle, this one is the pronator teres muscle. Then flexor digitorum superficialis muscle. Okay, then coming downward there is flexor pollicis longus muscle. Okay, then this one is the pronator quadratus muscle and the last there is radial bone itself which is also in the posterior relation. Okay, so let us write down all. So first is bicep tendon, then there is supinator muscle, then there is pronator teres muscle, then there is flexor digitorum superficialis muscle, then flexor pollicis longus muscle, then pronator, quadratus, and then radius bone itself. Okay, so these are all the posterior relations, and the anterior relation is only one muscle, and then it is superficial. Okay, now let's see the medial relation. So for the medial relation in this diagram, this is lateral side and this one is the medial side. So this is our radial artery. Okay, this complete. So you can see in the upper part there is pronator teres muscle, and then below this pronator teres there is flexor carpi radialis. Okay, so these two structures are in the medial relation. Okay, you can see through the whole course. So in the medial relation there is pronator teres, and then flexor carpi radialis muscle. Okay, now lateral relation. So first of all there is this brachioradialis muscle. Okay, then this is the radial nerve. Okay, this nerve is the radial nerve. So these two structures are in the lateral relation. Okay, see, this one is also in the is in the lateral relation throughout its course. Okay, this is the radial artery and this is the tendon of this brachioradialis muscle, which is in the lateral relation throughout the course. Okay, so let us write down brachioradialis muscle, and then there is radial nerve. Okay, so these two structures are in the lateral relation. So this is all about the relations. Now let us talk about the branches. Okay, so there are four branches of radial nerve artery. Branches, first is the radial recurrent. Okay, recurrent means which is going upward. Okay, which is going in the opposite direction. So radial recurrent, which participates into the anastomosis around this region, anastomosis around the elbow. Then second branch is for muscles, muscular branches. Then there is one superficial branch which participate into the superficial palmar arch. Then there is deep branch also, which is palmar carpal branch. Okay, so these are the four branches. So let us write down. First is radial recurrent artery. Second is the muscular branches. Third is the superficial palmar branch, and fourth and last is the palmar carpal branch. Okay, so this is all about the branches. Now there is one clinical point that the radial pulse which we take in the wrist region is from this artery. Okay, so radial pulse is taken, or simple, the pulse is taken from the radial artery. Okay, from radial artery, when in this region, when it is present over this bone, we can feel the palpation over this region. Okay, so by this we can get the pulse. So this is all about the radial artery. Hope you guys like the video. If you like it, give it a thumbs up and share this video with your friends, and also subscribe the channel. Don't forget to press the bell icon. Thanks for watching the video.